I came to this strange world hoping I could learn a bit about how to give and take. But since I came here, felt the joy and the fear, finding myself making every possible mistake.
Child marriage is the union between an older male over the age of 18 and someone that's...
It's basically, in a lot of countries, very foreign to our roles, usually in Eastern countries, like on the Eastern side of the world, it's when they're organized... they have organized marriages, usually organized by the father or the mother, and they organize their child to marry someone,
child
usually
their friend. When a minor is engaged to or married to... older person. So someone who's older than a minor, I guess. And this causes problems because sometimes it's being abused for certain purposes, such as sex and power.
I would say that a man over the age of 18 marries someone younger than 18.
Child marriage is when a young child usually is forced to marry.
Child marriage is intermarriage between a youth person and possibly maybe a person of older age.
I would define child marriage as someone being under the age of 21, getting married or being forced to marry. You know, when you think of getting married, you think of
when a young child is married off to a person who's a lot older than them.
I think child marriage is when girls under the age of around, I guess, 13, they're normally around that age, 13, 14, and below, are married off to much older men, usually for financial reasons.
Not westernized cultures, and like the fact that they have to go to these children, very, very young children, to seek that virginity is just gross. And the fact that, like, if a girl sleeps with one man, she's now trash, you know. And so, there are so many girls that are being married young to find that virginity that soon they're gonna be married younger and younger because they're gonna get all taken up. And by the time that they're what, like 50, 60, are they even alive anymore? Like, what is like.
If one abused, it's a bad thing, but I mean, if a minor is in love with someone who's older than him or her, I think that shouldn't be illegal. But I do think it's abused in a lot of places, such as Nigeria.
I have two daughters, so I can't I can't really agree with it. I don't agree with it, but I'm pretty sure there's some things in my culture that people don't agree with either. So, from my particular standpoint, I don't agree with it because I wouldn't want to give my daughters off at 14 and 16, but,
I think it's okay. The reason why Americans, they don't understand it, they really disagree with it, is because we're not used to that. America is founded on the idea of individual freedom, individualism, and other countries, they really don't. Like, these other countries, they have wonderful economies, like, everything works for them because they have these organized lives. Also, like, child marriage or organized marriages have a much lower statistical rate of divorce than other marriages, than like free marriages. And so I really think it's just like an outlook on culture. We don't understand the culture, but to them, it's totally normal. There's nothing wrong with it.
When it's in her case, I don't see a problem with it because he never treated her wrong. He never, like, you know, abused her or anything. But I know there are many young girls that are married off as children, and they are treated badly, I would say. They're taken advantage of, and they're forced to do things that they probably shouldn't be forced to do at such a young age.
The elders should give it, they should give a child the opportunity to grow, mature, have understanding of life before getting into marriage. Marriage is a serious and it's a lasting issue. It's not something a child should be dealing with because they don't have any understanding.
Disgusting. It doesn't make any sense for you to want to be with somebody that's younger than you when there are other people that could be around your age or that could be older than you. Just marrying someone that's under the age of 18 and you're not under the age of 18 doesn't really make any sense.
They are not fully prepared and fully aware of what future they can give to their children, or just the husband and wife, what future they are going to get because they're too young. They are not so much prepared with how to be a dad and how to be a mom. So they need to be at the school at that age. They need to prepare.
I don't think anybody should be forced into a marriage against their will.
How can I that a senator of Nigeria will push for child slavery to be made legal?
Wrapped around my finger and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, it could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you, won't let no one break your heart, no, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. And never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies and you're mortified. Your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do and you can't wait to move.
Maybe like an incident of rape happened or something, and they have to cover up their daughter's like act
based on physical maturity, which is why it's happening to 13 and 14 year olds. They don't see
or maybe because of family problems, maybe of things that there are also some people who want an early marriage, just like my mom. My mom got married only when she was 14 years old.
Because that's what their culture is. That's what their tradition has been probably for years, and I guess, you know, they probably don't want to change that. Baby girls are all right. Like, they marry them to someone who's already established in the world.
Yeah,
and
has
from time you would marry your kids off because they were a burden to your family.
Back in the day when people would get bored, it's probably a mental thing where you find younger versions of people cuter than the older ones. That's a thing. They do that. That's like, I like older guys. It's like that. It's just how you see
to society, you can get the daughter or son, I guess, to marry that individual with like their status within
Well, I know in Nigeria, my grandmother, she was married to my grandfather as a child. He's much older than her. And it was because she was from a poor family, and my grandfather's family was well-to-do. So...
Well, a long time ago, like, in the olden days, they would do it for money and relationships, and basically because families wanted to be a part of other families. So it really had nothing to do with people who were getting married, it was just the people behind it.
The family of the man, they offer the woman's family money.
Because it does, that's their culture. It's like asking a Christian like why does communion exist or whatever, you know? It's like it's what they do, it's their culture.
Children opportunity to grow and mature and have, you know, understanding of what they're getting into. Not just go there and then doing, no, I don't think
that's
really
important anymore, and everything is modernized now, so there's no thing for it anymore.
Those cultures, the heck? No.
I wouldn't want to ban what somebody believes in their culture. If they believe in their culture, that when a child, when a young woman has reaches a certain age where she can reproduce and she's able to be a wife or whatever to another man, then, you know, that's their particular culture. But I wouldn't want nobody going against my beliefs or how I feel, my tradition, so I wouldn't want to go against
I think there should be restrictions put on it, and because it's not morally correct. It's not fair to the child.
Tough question. I guess if I had the power, I would say that, but that's being pretty ignorant of other cultures and other traditions.
Well, no, I don't think that, because, you know, like I said, it has been a part of people's cultures for a while, and, you know, you can't just be like, you can't do that anymore, and, you know, people have been doing it and practicing it for, like, hundreds to thousands of years, you know.
That's, I think she's banned, but I think she's discouraged because of...
It's completely, like, it really works better. I don't believe in it. Like, I wouldn't want an arranged marriage because I believe in, like, individual freedom. But it's honestly a cultural aspect. It's not our own culture, but it's something that exists. It's not something that we should get rid of.
But I think it will be very hard to make that happen since it's such a deep part of certain cultures.
No. Well, I don't exactly know the definition of child marriage, so no, I'm not going to put a stand on that.
I'm not saying to ban worldwide, but it depends. If you give students, so I'm teacher and you're my student. If you will just tell your students that early marriage is not good one for you, try to encourage them not to get married or not to get married at an early age because they need to prepare also their future. And tell them or encourage them not to be in a hurry because boys are just around you, girls are just around you. So you can choose your future husband or your future wife, but be sure that you are very much prepared because at the end, who will suffer? The children. And would you like to see your children without this, without that, and then the friends of your children got everything they wanted? So it will be, how you say that, broken heart or disgusted or disappointed. Imagine your neighbors could give everything to their children, but you cannot give because you don't have any to give.
Child marriage and slavery. If anything, child marriage is worse. How can you subject a 13-year-old child to that kind of life? A child who's yet to figure out her bearing in life. A child with hopes and dreams. A child that has a right to freedom, a right to education. Has Nigeria suddenly run out of mature girls who are fully developed and ripe? I cannot believe that such a barbaric, an extremely degrading issue will be discussed by the Senate in a country like Nigeria that is described as the giant of Africa.
Golly, that's a bad golly, wow. Oh, edit it.